Hello, we're here today, in fact, to have a quick conversation with Dr. Claudia Wong, who is a lecturer in the Department of Linguistics. And she will be talking to you a little bit more about two of the courses she will be teaching remotely in the fall. Dr. Wong, what are you going to teach in the fall?
Well, I'm teaching Linguistics 111 and 200 in the fall semester.
Can you remind us, the one I think is an introduction to English vocabulary, and the other one is the introduction to English sentence analysis. Can you let us
That's
know
correct.
A little bit more about the questions that you will be trying to answer in those two courses?
Okay, so basically in Linguistic 111, because as the name implies, we are looking at everything related to word analysis, anything related to vocabulary formation, or how, for example, some words make sense to us, it's going to be an intro level, and we are targeting at almost all students. Even you are not directly like related to, for example, linguistics department, if you're interested, if you want to know more about word formation or how people create words, because one of the topics, for example, is constructed languages, for example, the language used in the movie Avatar. So we are looking into all these very interesting topics together. So you're very welcome to join.
Perfect. Can you let us know a little bit more about the Linguistic 200 course, the Introduction to English Sentence Analysis?
Sure. So the 200 is slightly more advanced than the 111, the level one course, and it is basically dealing with grammar. It's an introduction to syntax. So basically, we're looking at how we make use of all the grammatical properties of English and form a sentence grammatically. What does it mean by grammatically correct, right? So we are looking into things like that. Also, we will be trying to sort of understand why some sentences sound or looked very weird to us in processing. And you can see on the screen later, for example, this, I have given you two examples, and we are trying to understand why. Those are very strange, weird sentences.
Now, of course, fall 2020 is not the same fall as we would normally have. All courses are taught remotely. Can you tell us a couple of the activities that you're planning to do in your classes to address this remote teaching reality?
Sure. So I am going to do a blended learning approach. So basically, half of my class will be online, and that means asynchronously done. And during every week, I will include learning activities that you have to do before class. It might be quizzes, it might be some short questions that I have created for you, or it might be maybe a short video watching, or even my own mini lecture videos. Usually it's no longer than 15 minutes. So there will be a range of activities that you have to do on your own before attending the live lecture, which will be approximately 1.5 hours. So during the live lecture, we will go through all the things you have done before class and we'll give you feedback. And based on that, we will also learn more new topics together. So at the end of the class, we will give you maybe one or two very short post-class learning activities so that you can consolidate and read more on the topic you're interested. That's pretty much how we work with the remaining of the semester.
This sounds as if the students have a lot of opportunity also to connecting with you. How would you encourage the students? What could they do, in fact, if they have a question? How would they go about that?
Yeah, so I have created not only online forums on Canvas. They, of course, can email us because we have online office hours. So we can set up a time and we can do Canvas Blackboard Collaborate Ultra meeting. Or if students prefer to be more informal, we also have a Facebook closed group usually for our course, and students usually share questions and other classmates who see the questions can respond. And of course, I'll be monitoring the page, and we can even set up a Facebook meeting together to talk about that, which I have done already in my previous class.
Perhaps as the last question, what about tests and quizzes and assignments? How will you be grading in these classes?
All right, so in my course, in two of my courses, I won't have any exams. So all the assessments will be done throughout the semester. And I strongly recommend everybody to start following the timeline and start early. And that will be usually a very equal distribution of group work and individual work. So you don't have to do everything on your own, because I understand that maybe during this challenging time, it will be better to have somebody to help you do your work. So it also helps, you know, with collaborative learning as well. So yeah, you don't have to worry about being put under stress, like, you know, doing the tests.
Any last words of encouragement to the students who are enrolled in your class and who are all excited, perhaps a little bit anxious in starting it? What would you tell them?
I would say, you know, this is a pretty much introductory level class to linguistics, and we really want you to enjoy it, because you can see how close we are to all these so-called linguistic theories. So when students think about linguistics, they might think, oh, it's something hard, I don't understand. But if you take these two courses, you will realize that, oh yes, that makes sense. And you can see that's almost like every day in your life. So I encourage you just to enjoy, participate, and that's it.
Thank you so much, Dr. Wong. I'm sure that all of the students who are currently enrolled in the classes will be looking forward now to starting their first class with you in September. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks.